Jesus to Pastor Bryson, Minister Moore, Minister Benson, Minister Cox, Minister Wien. Amen. Amen. Minister Lawson, to all you who are here in our Heavenly Father's house on this day, we greet you in the awesome name of Christ Jesus. I want to thank God's unsung. Sing like that, you make the preacher's job a lot easier. Amen? Amen. That's why it is important for the praisers to go first. Amen. Sit at the table.
Today, fish and swim
with you. Because it really isn't that deep. When you're on your job, and there's some money that doesn't belong to you, that is there and you want to take it, because you find yourself financially between a rock and a hard place, if you're in the deep too long and forget about the 1, 2, 3 ABCs, your integrity will be compromised by taking the money. And we all make excuses for doing it, but it isn't that deep. Thou shall not steal.
Through grace and faith in our Lord and Savior, Christ Jesus. In other words, we get a new beginning. We get a new start by accepting Christ as our Savior. In 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter, verse 17, reads, "Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new." Brand new start through Christ Jesus. Now that salvation has come through Christ, we're no longer orphans, but we're children of the Most High God. Because of the blood of Christ, we have now been reconciled back to the Father. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus was the only one that could get us back in good grace with the Father. You know, there is a question that so many people are fighting about today. They're fighting over, when does life really begin? You have the pro-choice and the pro-life, and they are. When does life begin? Some people say at conception. Others say when you hear the heartbeat. And then others say after the first, the second, or the third, or half a trimester. And I say it that way because I've never been pregnant. Don't know nothing about it. Wherever I've been trimesters there are. But as for me, life begins at confession instead of conception. Life begins at confession and not conception. Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10 says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. This, my brothers and sisters, is everlasting. In the text, God the Father is speaking to us, his children. That's relationship. That's the Father speaking to us, his children. He goes on to say that if we sin, we have an advocate. We have someone fighting for us. We have someone standing in the gap for us. We have an advocate with the Father through the righteousness of Christ Jesus. And that's good news to know. Because the more we learn about Jesus Christ, the less likely we will sin. The more we learn of him. But we do have an advocate in Christ Jesus. And I thank God for the advocate. Because the Bible declares that all have sinned and fall short. Amen? But God's desire for his children is for us to grow. That's his desire, for us to grow. We shouldn't stay baby Christians all of our lives. This is Christian education, son. In 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 2, it reads, "As newborn babes, desire the the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby. Please, Zach. The sincere milk of the word of God. Now, I know you don't want to hear this, but it is true. It is a growing process. It's a growing process. And some don't want to hear that, but it is a growing process. And some of us will grow faster than others. But come on, man. How in the world can you be a Christian for 60 years and still hold a 60-year grudge against your brother and sister? You would think by 60 years, all kinds of might have said it, and you done forgot about what you're mad about anyway. But you simply get mad because you don't recognize that face. Come on, man. How is it that we can be a Christian for 60 years, and when we don't get out of the way, we sit there like a child and throw them tantrum tantrums? Come on, man.
Amen.
Amen. And sometimes we downplay the importance of our progression. And as it been said, I would rather see a sermon than hear one any day. The Word of God teaches us that faith without works is dead. Our faith in God moves us to bear witness to the power of God working in our lives. God has called His people to be on the move. You can't stay in here. We have to take it to the street. And I don't know about you, but every now and then when the Holy Ghost really get a hold of me, I'm like Jeremiah. This like fire. Shut up in my bones. And I got to move. We're on the move. We're to be His witnesses. Why? Because in Acts chapter 1 it says what? We shall receive power. After the Holy Ghost has come upon us. And He said that we shall be His witnesses unto both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and into the utmost parts of the world. We should be His witnesses. We should be on the move. We shall have His power to spread the gospel of Christ. As believers, as witnesses of the Lord Christ Jesus, we should be growing now into perfection. We should look and walk and move like Christ more and more. Each and every day we should look and act and talk like Christ. We have a great example. We have a great example to follow. We have Jesus Christ. So the Bible says, even as Christ walked, we should walk. Let us focus on the Lord Christ and not on the faults and failures of others. People will fail you, but Jesus, He never fails. We are not perfect. By no means we are perfect. But Jesus is. And if we are to walk and talk and look like Him, then we too must discipline ourselves according to the Word of God. Hebrews 12 and verses 1 and 2 says, wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and sin which do easily beset us. And let us run with patience the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before Him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down now at the right hand of the throne of God. We need to get rid of that some of that garbage, or all of that garbage, amen. Lay aside anger, malice, bitterness, hatefulness, lay it aside. Lay it aside. My brothers and sisters, we may not look exactly like Christ. Not right now. But one of these old days, we'll be able to see Jesus for ourselves. And we will be like Him. In 1 John chapter 3, verse 2, it says, beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it does not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Amen. We'll be like him. We'll see him. We'll see him face to face. And I don't know about you, but I want to see Christ. Amen. I want to see the man who died for me. Amen. I want to see him. And I